case is Rolando Ortiz. He's 37 years of age. The victim is his 2-year-old biological son. The victim would have turned 3 in March. The victim's mother and defendant have 3 children together, including the victim and 2 older children. They all reside at a residence on the 2700 block of South Avers in Chicago, Cook County, Illinois. Both the defendant and the victim's mother work opposite shifts in the same factory. The mother works the day shift, the defendant works the night shift. The 2 older children attend school during the day. On February 21st, 2018, the victim's mother went to work, and the 2 older children went to school. The defendant came home from working that night and was alone in the residence watching the 2-year-old victim. While at the residence with the victim, the defendant brought the victim into bed with him so he could sleep. The 2-year-old would not fall asleep. The 2-year-old would not stop moving around and jumping on the defendant. The defendant grew frustrated when he was unable to fall asleep. When the 2-year-old got up off the bed and began running around the residence, the defendant jumped out of his bed, grabbed his son by the arm. The defendant pinned the child on the kitchen floor so the child could not move. As he held the child down, the defendant reached over and grabbed a large kitchen knife from a nearby table. The defendant then held his son down with one hand and used the knife in the other hand to slice across the child's throat multiple times, killing the 2-year-old. The defendant then placed the body of the son in a garbage bag. He wiped the blood off the kitchen floor with some dirty clothes and then placed those bloody clothes in the bag with the body of the son. After the murder, he called a witness and told her that his son was with God and that he killed his son. The witness alerted other family members. 2 witnesses went to the residence and found the defendant in the residence alone. The defendant told them that his son was dead. Those witnesses kept asking where the 2-year-old, but the defendant would not respond. They searched the apartment and found the garbage bag containing the boy's body under the kitchen table. After they found the body, they called 911. As police and ambulance sirens approached, the defendant fled the area in his truck. Chicago police were able to trace the defendant via a cell phone to a location to take the key, where he was placed under arrest and brought back to Chicago.